Let's talk now about a new concept, that being the idea of both correlation and simple linear regression. The next series of several videos will talk about these two concepts. Specifically in this first one, I'm going to emphasize the idea of correlation. Now, like usual, let's talk about the learning objectives. What we want to do is be able to visually determine if a linear or curvilinear relationship exists between two quantitative variables. I want to measure and interpret the strength of a linear or a monotonic relationship, and I will talk quite a bit about what exactly it means for something to have a monotonic relationship. And I construct and interpret the regression equation. The regression equation makes reference to a simple linear regression relating two quantitative variables. And, of course, like usual, we want to be able to make inferences regarding the population parameters. Okay, now, first off, let's start talking about Pearson's correlation. Pearson's correlation is a measurement of linear association. And the linear part is extremely important. It's an appropriate tool to use for measuring the strength of linear association between two variables, or between a variable. The type of measurement applies only to data, which has a measurement scale of, it has to be at least interval, so that means it must be a measurement scale of interval or ratio. Now, by bivariate, what I mean by that is I'm going to take two measurements from the same object, and I'm looking for an association between them. As the variable, or as one value changes, do we see a change in the other? That's not the same as saying one's causing it, and we'll talk quite a bit about causation a little bit later, but am I seeing a change in one as a change in the other occurs? That's the association. So as a quick example, perhaps you take a look at the number of hours per week studied. And say course score. Course score used for your grade, and let's say that's in a percent. So we have at least interval for both of these variables. Now, what you expect to happen is somebody that studies few hours to have a low score, and is somebody that studies a lot of hours to have a high score. Now, that's the type of thing you'd expect to happen. So, if you collect data, what you're probably going to see is something like this, whereas some people can get away with studying few hours but get good scores, and other people study lots of hours and get good scores, but if I draw a line around this just really lightly, not looking for too much detail there, or the idea here is what I'm seeing is generally some type of linear trend. And this looks like a positive linear trend. If this is the sort of thing that I see in my data, then that is actually suggesting that Pearson's correlation is probably the appropriate tool to use to measure the strength of this association. How strongly is one variable related to the other? Let's talk briefly here about some notation. Now, specifically Pearson's correlation, the parameter value, the notation that we use for the parameter value is the Greek letter rho, looks like a P kind of tilted on its side, and the statistic is our lowercase r, and it measures linear association. Now, the other type of correlation that we will talk about is called Spearman's. And the parameter is also rho, but what we do is we subscript it with an S, so now we know we're talking specifically about Spearman's. And the statistic is once again R, and again we will subscript that with an S, so we know we're talking specifically about Spearman's. And this is a measurement of monotonic association. And like I said earlier, we will discuss the idea of monotonicity a little bit later. Now, something that's extremely important to understand is that the value of the correlation coefficient, whether it's a parameter value or the statistic, it doesn't matter, it always will reside on -1 to 1. It is mathematically impossible for the correlation coefficient to be either greater than 1 or less than -1. It's impossible. Can't happen, period. So What does it mean to have a correlation of 1 or negative 1? Well, let's take a look at that. If I were to do a scatter plot, and my scatter plot looked like this, that data is perfectly lined up, well, at least to my best of my ability to draw it. This would have a correlation of R equals positive 1. See, the slope is positive, hence correlation is positive. Now, on the other hand, if it was, had a negative slope and perfectly lined up, that would be R equals negative 1. So R equals positive 1 is a perfect positive trend. So R of 1.2 has no meaning. What does it mean to be more perfect than a perfect linear trend? It doesn't make any sense. And if you actually look at the way that the statistic is calculated, it's impossible mathematically to even get a value bigger than 1. And if negative 1 means it has a negative trend but it's perfectly lined up, then what's negative 1.3 mean? It has no meaning. Now, what we see happening is in our data, if you think of starting at 1, where it's perfectly lined up, in reality, you're going to get some variation. So it starts to spread out, starts to look like a cigar shape, and then maybe more of a football shape, and then to a cloud, which is a blob. As I go from perfectly lined up to this blobby cloud, I'm going from 1 to 0. And if the data starts or looks like it has a negative trend to it and goes from that blob down to a perfectly straight line, we're going from 0 to negative 1. So as an example, something like this, if I just loosely draw a line around it, not trying to get too detailed, I'm seeing something that looks positive, a positive trend of some type. This may have a correlation of like maybe 0.85 or something like that. That's a positive. Whereas something like this, if I just loosely draw a line around it, see, this is clearly a negative trend, and this may have a correlation of maybe negative 0.85 or negative 0.8 or something like that. On the other hand, something like this, this is a blob. If I loosely draw a line around it, it's basically a blob. See, up here, look at correlation of 1 again. If I have a value here, call it x1, I know exactly what y is. Here, this value, call it x2, again, I know exactly what y is. There's absolutely no doubt. It's perfectly correlated. And the exact same idea exists here for the negative correlation. Now, on the other hand, if I have a value of x here, there's a range that these y values can fall in. So it's not as exact. Hence, the reason why the correlation coefficient, the value, moves towards zero, no association. The blob here is if I start moving, take values of x here or values of x here, this range is basically the same no matter where I am. So as I change values of x, it tells me nothing about what's going on with y, nothing at all. So this has a correlation of approximately zero. Now, there are other configurations that will also give us correlations of zero. Suppose you look at data, and it kind of looks like this. I'm sure you agree immediately there is an extremely strong association here. Boy, you give me x, and I could tell you exactly what y is. There's no doubt about that. This looks like a sine wave of some type. But Pearson's correlation measures what? Linear association. This is not linear. Pearson's correlation, if you actually use the data like this and actually calculate Pearson's R, you will get R equals zero. Likewise, suppose you had data that was perfectly lined up, but it was horizontal. Here, if I have x1 and x2, this value of x gives me this value of y, this value of x gives me the same value of y. So does changing values of x tell me anything about y? No, there's no association. Knowing x tells you nothing about y. And the last one, let me erase this guy and slip it in. That I want to show you here quickly is if you have data that is a vertical line, see, it's perfectly lined up, but x isn't changing. So given the value of x, the only x that you have, what's it tell you about y? Nothing. All your y's are there. It tells you nothing. So this would also have correlation of zero. And likewise, I didn't write it on here, but this should have correlation of zero. Let me see one more real quick. Let me erase this. This will also have correlation of zero. Why? It's not linear. Pearson's going to look at this and say, what the heck's going on? Just by the change in x and change in y, this is linear. This is really nice. This is perfect. And this is perfect. But it's a V or maybe a W or something like that. You could get correlation of zero every time if you use Pearson's correlation. It's the wrong tool for that type of data. All right, let's jump into a quick example. Finger Lakes. Fishermen in the Finger Lakes region have been recording the dead fish they encounter while fishing in the region. The Department of Environmental Conservation monitor the pollution index for the Finger Lakes region. The data table below show this information for the 8 years spanning 1987 to 1994. Now, there's two different questions I want to get to here. Number one, is there a linear association between the pollution index and the number of dead fish? See, there's my two variables, pollution index and the number of dead fish. And the second question is, if there is a linear association, can we produce a reliable model for the prediction purposes? This is actually making reference to simple linear regression, which I will get into in a future segment. And this is making reference to correlation. It's supposed to be two R's, correlation. All right, here's actually a map of Finger Lakes. It's in the New York region. It's in New York, and it's kind of obvious why they call it Finger Lakes, because they all look like fingers. But this is the lakes that the data was actually taken from. Now, what I suggest you do is pause the presentation and enter this data into your calculator. And if you want to follow along with my keystrokes, I put L1. I used L1 for the pollution index and L2 for deaths. The year is just extra information. We don't need to enter the year. That's not data that we're actually going to be working with. So go ahead and pause the presentation and enter that data, then we'll keep going. Okay, I'm assuming that you have the data entered now. And the very first thing I want to do is a scatter plot. Okay, so I'm going to bring up my calculator. And second, stat plot. I will work with stat plot 1. The very first icon is a scatter plot. You recognize these as the box plots and histogram stuff you've done before. And I have my X data in L1. That's my pollution index. And in Y or in L2, I have the deaths. Now, if you're doing nothing but correlation, it doesn't really matter what you put into L1 and L2. The order for X and Y doesn't make any difference. But I know I want to do some prediction later if possible. And the idea behind prediction is, we take one variable. In this case, it's more logical to take the pollution index and use the pollution index to predict the number of dead fish, not the other way around. And if that's the case, then it's very important that I put my value of, or put the variable that I'm going to use to predict with on the horizontal axis, which is the x-axis. So that's why I set that up. I set it up like that for this time. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and zoom 9 it. And if you get a line like that, all that means is that you may have another function going in your calculator. Sometimes the lines are kind of odd. They go out at different angles. So if that happens, just goes to y equals. See, there's a function I had in there. Clear it out. I commonly will go down to y10, or actually y0. Make sure that's clear, because the normal plot program that we wrote uses y0, the 10th equation there, to store the line that we use for the normal plot. Okay, so I got rid of that now. I'll graph it, and that's what our graph looks like. So I want to draw that, or at least some reasonable facsimile of it. It looks something kind of like this, I think. Let me look at it again real quick. Yeah, that's close enough. Where are we? There we go. That's kind of close enough. I think there's one more dot there, but anyway, the general trend here, we can see, it looks like it's pretty much linear. It actually comes up better on my calculator. This really looks like it's probably linear. So this is saying, hey, you know what? It's probably a good idea to go ahead and use Pearson's correlation to measure the strength of that association. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, the command that I'm going to suggest that you use does a bunch of stuff for us. It's actually the same command we use later when we do regression. Now, think for a moment about this setup. Now, the data was pollution index and number of dead fish. It would seem reasonable that as the pollution index increases, the number of dead fish also increase. And that's kind of what we saw in the scatter plot. That's what it looked like. So what I want to do is set up a hypothesis test for rho right away, because the command we're going to use does all that at one shot. So the null hypothesis would be that rho equals zero. This is a statement saying that there is no association. And we're expecting a positive association, so the alternative hypothesis would be rho is greater than zero. This is saying there's a positive association or trend. Now, I'm going to specify alpha at 0.5. That seems kind of reasonable. Now, I'm going to go to my calculator and actually calculate the correlation coefficient. Now, there's one thing I want to do first, and you should do this, and you only have to do it once. Make sure your calculator is properly set up. Hit your second key, and then 0 for catalog. And then notice this A here. The A means you're in alpha mode. So I'm going to look for the letter D, which is right here. I'm going to click it because I want to jump quickly to the D's, because what I'm looking for is a command called diagnostic on. So if I just simply down arrow and keep go through this a little bit, I'm looking for, there's diagnostic off, there's diagnostic on. I'm going to select it, hit enter. Hit enter again, and it's good. What happens is if you don't have that turned on and your factory defect does not have it turned on, when you use a command that I'm about to show you, it will not calculate the correlation coefficient for you. So once it's turned on, you're good to go, unless you go back to your factory defaults or if you turn it off for some reason. So now I'm going to go to Stat, Test, hit the up arrow because what I'm looking for is at the bottom, and I'm looking for LINREG t-test. There it is. LINREG stands for linear regression t-test. Okay, and my x day is an L1, y day is an L2, frequency is 1, and my alternative hypothesis is greater than. And if you have anything in reg EQ, go ahead and clear it. We'll use that a little bit later when we actually do regression analysis. And now I'm going to calculate. And what I'm interested in the p-value, 4.3799. to E negative 4, so it's a very small p-value. I would definitely reject the null hypothesis. And I want to look down here and see what the correlation coefficient actually is. R is 0.9282. Okay, so I know that R equals 0.9282, and the p-value was 4.3 something or other, I forgot. Let's see, 4.3, where is it? There it is, 4.3799. So 4.37, close enough. E negative 4, which is approximately 0.0004. So this correlation looks like it's pretty strong. This p-value is saying it's probably not by chance, that there looks like there really is a trend. So state your decision. I'm going to reject the null hypothesis and state my conclusion. There is enough evidence to suggest a positive association between the pollution index and see the number of dead fish. So there definitely looks like there is an association there. Okay, that's really all there is to Pearson's correlation. That's really all we're going to be working with it. Now, what's going to happen if we have a situation that we had curvature in our data? Suppose we looked at our scatter plot, and it looked more perhaps something like this, where what I'm seeing when I draw my line is something that looks curved. Well, that's exactly what Spearman's correlation was designed for, and we'll take a look at that in the next video.